Yes. I've been wearing ponytails for, wow, I can't even remember the last time I gave myself a silk wrist. I used to do them often. And then, I'm not sure what happened, but I stopped. And my edges have been suffering from the tension from the ponytails, especially this back corner here. So I'm gonna give myself a silk wrist. Leave my hair straightened for hopefully a couple of weeks. So I'm not gonna talk too much. I'm just gonna jump right into giving myself a silk wrist. My hair is washed. Yeah, there is some damage from a while ago, and sure you'll notice that, but we're working on that. I'm gonna go in with some heat protectant and just spray that all over. Oh, this smells good. So use the heat protectant of your choice, and I'm gonna go in and create a few sections. I'm gonna, just so that I can detangle it. Drop my comb. So detangle it and just get that heat protectant through all my strands. So that was one of the mistakes I was making before. And not making sure that that heat protectant is getting all the way through. And it's clear to me that I need a trim. It's also something I haven't done in a very long time. Since COVID, I feel like all of these maintenance schedules have been just completely thrown off. And then getting back into some sort of maintenance routine has just not been happening. I'm just sipping on some coffee that I made earlier today while I'm doing this. And so, now there's that section, because once I comb through and get this heat protectant through, I'm going to start with blow drying first. So you can see the clear damage back here. But we're working on that. I'm gonna put some more heat protectant on all of this, and I'm gonna brush here and I'm gonna comb through. I'll just start from the ends and slowly work my way up until the brush just goes through, and that's that. So there's that twist, and I'm gonna put a little more heat protectant in this area too, and then start working the brush through. I'm starting from my ends and then working my way up. And then I'm going to twist this area and move over to the other side. And I will just blow dry one section at a time. I'm gonna get this towel off since it's wet. And allow that to dry. So now I will just clip away these sections that I'm not working on, and let me plug in my blow dryer. I love this blow dryer here, and the attachment is what I use. Makes it so much easier to blow dry your hand. I will these ends look horrible. I am just going in with my flat iron, and I will take a small section at a time. Give myself a middle part, and I'll section off a small piece lip. The rest. And I'll use another clip to section off even further from here. And now I'm just waiting for my flat iron to heat up and I'll jump into flat iron. This is just HSI flat iron. This indicator here goes from red to green and it's up to temperature. And I do have it on 450. Don't be like me. That's probably why I have heat damage. But we're hoping for the heat protectant. It will not do that. But as you can see, it heats up pretty quickly. I just plugged it in green and we're ready to go. I don't use the chase method. I honestly just use my fingers and pass. And I generally go in with probably about 2 passes per section. And if I accidentally go in with a bigger section, then I will go with more passes if needed. But as you can see, this is one of the areas that was suffering from the tension that I was putting on my edges with my tight ponytails and stuff. I want to give these areas a rest and figured more iron in them would do just that. Ooh, it's hot in here. But this is my hair. And now we'll just do this all around. And normally I would have bumped in a curl. I'll do one just so you guys can see. But because I know, so I just bumped in a little. I would have done that all around, but because I know the way my ends are looking, I'm probably gonna go in and trim my hair off camera. I'm just going to leave it straight because I know you guys can't really see, but that looks terrible. And definitely explains why my hair has been doing and acting like I can see several split ends. So we'll go in and take care of that. So now I'm just gonna take another section. And keep going. As you can see, a whole lot of hair. And so it takes me some time. Through this whole piece like this. And so this is what this silk dress looks like. I'm gonna go in and cut it like I said, and then you'll see the final look in the thumbnail. The back looks like I'll need to pass one more time before I cut it as well, which I'll do. I'm back. So I couldn't find my shears and I started styling my hair. To myself, why am I not just recording me styling my hair? Because the real reason why I got off is because I was talking about cutting my hair. And so I have a bunch of pin curls over here done, and I like the curls, and so that's what I do. So I go back around and take big areas, curl, pin, and then this one has quite a few curls and have been sitting for a while. I don't want it too curly, and so I'll take that pin off, curl that here, and pin. I'll do that all around. Curl. And that curl can come out right. A curl and pin. And as I'm laying the other side down, these will sat in the heat for some time. We'll be ready to let down shortly after too. Now I just have these bunch of curls just pinned up or clipped up, and now I will let this down and I'll leave this last section up for a little while just so the curls can kind of, or not. And I will finger comb it to my liking. And that is really it. Sometimes the middle part doesn't quite work out, and So but I will keep playing with it until I like the way it looks. And usually it's somewhere in the middle part. And somewhere along these lines. And yeah, I'll just play with it until I am happy. And I will find some shears and cut it at some point, but this is the final look of my press, silk press, from natural to silk press. Please give a like, don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching. Get into the shine. All right, bye for now.